In the park right now. This park is actually a dancing park, I guess. I think people come here and dance. And I'm with my mother-in-law and Ivan, as usual. And my mother-in-law's friends just invited us to, you know, hang out here, basically. So I'm gonna show you how it looks. There goes Ivan.
So guys, this is the lady who invited us to hang out with her, and we had already had lunch, but I decided to go anyways. And my mother-in-law was insisting. They are really good friends, and she came with her daughter-in-law, her husband and her grandson. So it was a good idea to take Ivan out because he had cold at this point and he wasn't happy in the house. So yeah, it was a good outing. It was a sunny day compared to other days because it was raining all the time. And basically these people just kept taking photos. Ivan was like star of the town. Everyone wanted to be with him and take photos with him. And just because he's so different, you know, and also so cute. Look how tall the daughter-in-law is. I was surprised, yeah, but some people can be really tall here in the north. And this garden is so big. And guys, I know you must think that this is not a garden, this is just like a vast space, but it's a dancing place. At night or in the evenings, people gather around, people start dancing here, and it's really nice. I'm gonna show you the evening scene here. So also guys, if you have not subscribed to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, leave a like and comment if you want to say anything. And I'm walking alone now, letting them do their photo session. And I see these flowers, they are really well maintained. Who comes really so far to take care of these flowers? This garden is literally out of the village, and there are solar panels on the lights here, and it looks nice. Basically I saw some old guys playing traditional Chinese music over there. I tried to record it, but later I saw it just didn't record. It's so crazy, this music is so similar to folk music of my hometown Rajasthan. I can't even tell you guys. This structure you see in the front, this is called traditional Chinese pavilion. People chill here just like the old times. I think she's gonna introduce me to these people now. This is a TikTok video they made with me. I mean, I was so awkward. I didn't know what to do. I just kept smiling, and the filters are all over the place, guys. These makeup filters. Yeah, it's very weird. So as I've said before, everyone knows everyone in the small towns of China. And my aunt, she just randomly starts talking to people on the street, and that's how everyone is. It's not only about this being a small town, it's also because Jilin is a very friendly place. North of China, people are very friendly and happy, and also very confident. So this is an observation, guys. Some barbecue here. And this lady is selling roast corn. You can see that device or that oven is actually used for roasting the corn, just like we use coal or barbecue to roast corn. Moving ahead, those look like colorful drinks which are sweet, and there is some mineral water. I've never tried them. I think it's not a good idea to try them. They make it here use colors and all. And here is barbecue. This is Odin's favorite thing in the world. Yeah, some sausages, some meat, and lot of tofu things, and I can see a pineapple. Yeah, this is pineapple, I guess, yellow, and they like to eat pineapple barbecue here. So this is mostly meat and tofu barbecue. We're gonna move ahead. I can already see an ice cream stall, and this looks like sunflower seeds in these big plastic bags. They eat that a lot here. And I've never tried ice cream before. I don't think I'll try. I try to eat only well-cooked and hot things on the street. It will keep you safe anywhere in the world. But otherwise, it's really clean here. I don't see any plastic or any garbage around these stalls. Here is some more barbecue, and I can see tofu. I can see more tofu and seafood here as well. So I think they have seafood more than meat here. And Odin loves seafood as well. Also, the quantity in Jilin is so huge. I mean, you can eat so much in very little money. And look at this. This is, I think, potato barbecue. Try this as well. And they even barbecue bread around here. Can you imagine that? Bread barbecued. So we were just walking and decided to check out this new store. It just opened and my aunt was interested. By the way, today a lot of people were asking me in the comments whether there was enough food in China, and they read somewhere in the news that people are starving and the food is not enough. So I don't know what to say to that. I really think it's very sad. Some websites, they post anything. Okay, now we are going across the road to see some street vendors for veggies. I think all these veggies are grown in the same town, and these people are farmers who take it early in the morning to sell here. I love these yellow tomatoes. I couldn't find them in the cities, and in India also I could only find them in my village. You can see people park their vehicles here and selling stuff. My aunt just realized that she doesn't have any cash right now, and I had to buy some veggies for Ivan. So she just asked this street guy to lend her some money, and he did. I mean, he didn't even know her. So that's how you can, you know, ask people for money and return it later. It's no problem. Does anyone know what is this called? It looks like sugar cane, but I have no idea. I didn't eat it. I still don't know what this is. Here my aunt is trying to pay money, and I say, no, let me pay. But she's like, no, I'm gonna pay. This dude was just so happy. I don't know why he was happy. He was talking a lot. I couldn't understand it, of course, but he seemed really happy to talk. And he went to his truck to take some veggies and take this weighing scale. I haven't seen it for a long time. I never see it in China, but my mom has this at home and she uses it for vegetables and stuff. We were ready to pay, but this man kept measuring it, and we were just waiting for him to get done. It was really funny. This guy is typical North Chinese guy, tall with a sharp nose, just like Odin. Yeah. So these two dudes were also sitting there. They started talking, so pretty much everyone was talking on the street. And now that I think of it, people like to talk a lot in Jilin, especially in the small towns. People live a very relaxed life. They like to eat. They like to talk to each other every day. They like to dance in the evenings. And they buy local food, local veggies. And they don't seem busy at all. They are always ready to go out with you, spend all day outside. They don't have to go anywhere. They don't have to rush to an office or anything. So guys, that's it for today. Enough of this chit chat and vlog. I'm gonna go back to Ivan. I missed him so much because he was not in my sight for a long time. And here is my mother-in-law with him waiting for us. I'll see you soon next time. This time with a family lunch at home, guys. Bye bye.